and how I think technology should be used. Okay, you've probably seen something like this before. It's a learning matrix. There's some other names for it. Basically, all of them have some basic form of level of engagement and the depth of learning, right? Keeping in mind that really requires two things to be successful at anything we implement, right? You need to have a high level of engagement, keep kids interested in what they're doing, but just having high level of engagement if you're, you know, shooting, you know, baskets with wadded up pieces of paper, that's not really a lot of depth of learning. So the trick is you have to have, right, obviously some learning that's happening with that level of engagement. In other words, the idea is we want both of our activities to be kind of in those green squares, right? Kind of medium to high in both areas. That doesn't mean you can't venture out these other areas. It's okay, right? I loved playing in music and band when I was in school. And so what we do is just fun, right? Going and playing pep band at the basketball game, it's a ton of fun. Is there a ton high depth of learning happening there? Not really, you know, I mean, playing Louie Louie, you know, but it's fun, engagement's high. So that's, and that's okay. So it doesn't mean that you can't venture out of those realms, but, you know, sometimes you need to practice your scales, which is kind of boring. The depth of learning is pretty high, right? So, but that's the key idea. We just want to try to stay out of that red area as much as possible. Now, it's inevitable we're going to get there, but that's the key idea, right? So worksheets are not typically that engaging. They can be, but they're typically not. The depth of learning can be high, but not necessarily. The problem comes in this kind of one-size-fits-all problem, right? So if you're, and I did this for years, everyone do problems 1 through 20, right? Everybody's doing problems 1 through 20. And I think Bill Gates said it best. He said, the problem with American textbooks is that they're made for the average student. The average student that doesn't exist. And what he means is simply, when we think about a distribution, right? The average might actually be at pretty low engagement and low depth of learning, but you know, a couple of those kids is actually pretty good. That's exactly what they needed. But not our entire class, right? That's the problem with that model. That's the problem with that model. So what would you do about that model? Well, another way you can do it is you can have different levels of practice. I mean, that one solution, right? And that can be handled by choices, things like that. Really, the only way to really make that high depth of learning and is it's going to have to be pretty highly individualized, which is really hard to do. Really hard to do. But if you can pull it off, the advantage is it actually kind of skews it, and actually the engagement actually goes up. This is the psychology of flow. The psychology of flow says the brain actually likes challenges. It does, right? That's why video games are popular, right? It likes challenges, but if that challenge is too easy or too hard, then you're going to be frustrated or bored. But if that challenge is just right, you actually get a positive dopamine effect. It becomes pleasurable. It feels good, right? And that's the trick. And that's why if you can highly individualize it, you do get more engagement out of it.